Hey guys, how are you today? Alrighty, I am here to bring you this month's design team challenge for my rubber stamp line, which is stickers. Now, in case you don't know, I have my own line of rubber stamps. I wrote a book last year. I've got a bunch of digital downloads, artwork. There's a set of downloadable prompt cards that you can buy in my, all available in my Etsy shop. So, and there's more things coming at the filming of this. There's more things coming I can't talk about yet. These are my rubber stamps. These are all 11 different sets that I have currently available at the filming of at this time. And we are going to do some fun things. I want to give you some ideas of stuff you can do with these and create some inexpensive, cute, unique stickers using these stamps or any others. All right, so before we decide what stamps we're using, and I think I kind of already know already, but we're gonna take some stickers. Now, I know a lot of you are thinking, you know, okay, I don't have a sticker machine. I don't have the money to go buy like fancy like sticker paper. You don't need any of that stuff. All right, so I'm gonna prove it to you. So this is my bin from my shelf behind me that says packaging, stickers, labels, and receipt paper. Because literally that's what it is. It's actual receipt. This is from some fabric I bought at Hobby Lobby. They gave me the thing, so I stuck it in here. These are rolls of adding machine tape and receipt paper and different kinds of found and stickers and things that have been given to me. These are luggage tag stickers from a cruise I went on with my husband. These are airline suitcase stickers from the last time. I have a few of these from when I've gone on trips. These are the leftover bits, and you know, so most of this is just paper. These are from prescriptions. The most of it is just paper that can actually be thrown away. This part, these are actually labels that generally speaking go on your prescription bottle, but not always. So I have those. That needs to be thrown away. I have priority mail labels. We're actually going to pull a couple of those out because we're going to use those. I found a whole thing of reinforcements in a drawer somewhere. So those are in here. I've got a sticky label that was from something I ordered. In case I wanted to return it, they sent an extra self-adhesive label. Well, I never did return it, and I have the label, so I'm going to use that. So I have all these kind of things I've been saving. I have more of those like FedEx labels. You don't need to have fancy stuff, just stuff that you find. We're going to actually use these, and I'm going to use some of these luggage labels too. Yeah. So let's see if I can like separate this. Yep. Okay. So the first thing you want to do with some of these is you want to, you can use it as is, but I like to put a thin coat of gesso on here. So that's what this is, and I'm going to actually just do it this way. If I can get the top off, there we go. Bubble. There we go. So I'm going to just take a little bit of gesso. Just a little bit. That's plenty. That might be too much. And I'm going to take an old gift card. And I'm going to just push some of those barcodes and printing into the background of the sticker. I'm not going to try to cover them up completely. I know that's way too much gesso. I'm not going to try to cover them up completely, but I want them to be less obvious. This is what you do when you're trying really hard not to make a mess and failing completely. All right. Okay, so we're going to do that. And then let's give it a dry.
Thank you.
Okay, now I don't want to just leave it with the gesso. I'm going to put some color on there. I just literally just grabbed some random colors. This is Distress Paint in Broken China. I'm going to put a couple of drops. This is Americana Neon Paint in Torrid Orange. That's plenty. This is Claudine Hellmuth Studio Dash of Red. I had this little bottle for a long time. Whoa. Okay, we're not going to add any more of that because it's a lot of that. All right, then we're going to take the same gift card. So use colors that you know are going to, you know, blend fairly well and not create too much mud. Because for the most part, you don't want too much mud. Okay. I'm going to take what's left on here. And I'm going to grab my little delusions journal. And I'm going to open a blank page. There we go. Okay, now before I do anything else, I think I want to take this sponge applicator brush thing. And I'm just going to impress like a little pattern in the wet paint. Okay, so we need to dry that again. Okay, we're going to let that dry a little bit. I'm going to set it aside before we do anything else with it. And in the meantime, we are going to take these Priority Mail labels, and these have already been painted a long time ago. And I'm going to take my Art Doll set of stamps out, which is set number 10. And let's take one of the doll bodies. I want to use this one. I suppose if I'm going to play with stamps, I actually need to get out some ink. That would probably be helpful. I have lots of different kinds of ink, but for this we're going to use archival ink. And the first thing I'm going to do is stamp a doll body, and I think I want to stamp it on this one. Get it nice and inked up, and then I'm going to stamp the body. Okay, perfect. Then I'm going to take one of the faces, and I think I'm going to do this one. Stamp that over here in this little white space that I have. Yeah. Okay. Then I'm going to take one of the faces. This Art Doll set comes with faces. And I'm going to grab one of those. And try to get it in the oval. Without smearing it, hopefully. Yep. Then I have a number of different little embellishments that will fit in the Art Doll body. From a couple of different sets, and let's actually see. I think I want to stick with my original idea. I'm going to use this little heart. But there's other sets with other little embellishments that'll fit in the doll body. Okay. And now I need a little pair of scissors. All right, now we're going to cut these out. Not right on the stamp line, just a hair outside the line. Okay, and then the face. Now, if you wanted to do this and you wanted to, you could. There are a pair of wings on here. There are also words in most of my sets of stamps. You could stamp an inspirational word. Okay. And let's not forget our little heart. Okay, so then I'm going to zoom in. There we go. So then we can kind of do a build a sticker. Now, you could do a bunch of these different parts, bodies, faces, and embellishments, wings or no wings, and you could have a sort of build an art doll sticker set that you use or gift to a friend. I'm going to peel, hopefully. I'm trying to do this without my glasses on. That's probably not a great idea. Just FYI. Because I can't really see what I'm doing. I need my glasses. Or I need a pair of glasses. Alright, let's see if this helps. Oh, yeah. I can see the said edge. Alright. So I'm going to peel off my face and put it on my doll body. I'm going to peel my heart. Sounds really bad. I'm going to peel my heart. Okay, got it! Woohoo! So you have to kind of fold back a little corner until you can separate the layers, and then you can peel it. I'm going to put my heart here. And then she's ready to go. You could build the little art dolls and leave the backing paper on them and put it in a little something with a note to a friend that it's a sticker, and they can peel the back off and stick it to an art journal page. But how cute would she be on a tag or on a journal page? Cute, 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 right? All right, so I hope that gives you some ideas of what you can do with the stickers. The other thing you can also do is make some stickers that are for Happy Mail. So this kind of luggage tag thing is really great. Let's see. There we go. So let me grab this one from this set here. This is from set number 6. And I've lost track of what I'm doing. Okay, so you can use this sort of thing that you've gotten on your luggage from leftover from a trip. I never throw this stuff away. I always use it to make some kind of custom sticker. Because how cute is that? You could stick that on Happy Mail. You can stick it on a journal page. You can make a whole sheet of these stickers. And this particular set has 3 of these little, like, doodled drawn squares. Now, ideally, you want your paint to be completely dry when you do this. I'm doing this and it's just slightly damp. If you do it and you get paint on the rubber, red rubber stamp, that's okay. Just make sure as soon as you're done that you clean it right away. You can stamp with these on with black paint instead of with ink. I have done that. Again, just make sure you take your stamp right away and you take a baby wipe and you wipe the paint off and get it out of the holes of the stamp. If you need to, get a little finger brush in there and clean it up. All right?
I'm so inspired by these cute little art doll stickers that to do a journal page, like right here on this page. So we're going to do that really quick. Just a really quick page. This page already has paper on it from just leftover paint that I scraped on here with a palette knife or a gift card. And I honestly don't remember which now at this point. There we go. Got it. Sometimes getting these stickers started and getting the backing peeled is a little tough, but it's well worth it. They cost you nothing. There we go. Look around in your office and maybe your husband's office. Ask permission first if it's not your office. See if you have old shipping labels or that sort of thing that you're not using, and use those. There we go. So cute. And I found a quote here in my quote box that I thought would work on this page. So I just thought we'd toss something together really quick. It doesn't have to be complicated at all. Now, if you're worried about the stickers not sticking well to your page, then a little bit of gel medium under and over them, or matte medium, would not be a bad idea. I'm not worried about it. These are shipping labels, so they are going to stick really well. I'm going to trim this a little bit so it's straighter. And cut the words apart.
I think I want to do some splatters. I think. So we're going to take some white paint. This is just Americana craft paint, and the color is whitewash. Okay, my other bottle's empty, so we'll open a new one. Just need a little bit and some water. A brush. We'll do this before we put the words on. Now, remember I said I used archival ink. So I usually use archival ink because I can't guarantee what I'm going to do is not going to get wet at some point. And being able to get in here with the baby wipe and wipe the splatters off is a good example of that. So I don't have to worry about the ink moving or going anywhere. So now we're going to give it a quick dry. I hope it's dry. We're going to glue our words on. And I'll probably put enough matte medium on here to put a coat over the dolls to ensure that they stay on there. I'm going to not use that gift card because it's really gross. All right, let's use a fresh one. Oops.
cute is that? Simple page. I didn't do too much to it. And it's cute. I really like it. Holy moly. So there you have it. Something sweet, something simple, something quick, with just what I had laying around. So I hope that gave you some ideas of what you can do. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you want to buy a set of my stamps or anything else from my Etsy shop to help support the channel, the link is in the description below, along with the links to my Facebook groups, my address for Happy Mail, my email address if you want to ask a question, anything like that. It's all in the description below. Check it out. Don't be afraid either to leave a comment here in the video. I do respond to them every day, or at least I try to, every other day at the most. Don't forget, though, the most important thing, to go out and have a great day and do something nice for yourself, because you deserve it. I'll see you later. Bye, guys.